everyone, it's Lisa Mears here for Pretty Pink Posh, and today I'm going to be making a Valentine's Day card using some of the new products from the Pretty Pink Posh January release. So I want to start out by showing you the products I'll be using, and one of the stamp sets is going to be the Valentine Cupcakes stamp set. There's 6 cupcakes in this set, and I'll be using the cupcake in the top right corner, which is the one of the dog with the heart in its mouth. So cute. I'll also be using the Sweet Chocolates stamp set. I'll be using a couple of the chocolates from this set, as well as some of the hearts. I'm also going to be using the Eyelet Heart dies. These dies consist of 4 hearts, and they have a scalloped edge with some dots. There are 4 different sizes of these dies, and here is what it looks like once it's die cut. So you can see that beautiful scalloped edge with the polka dots. There's also some stitching in there. The sentiment that I'll be using is the Be Mine with the shadow. And the stencil that I'm using is the Half Hearts 2-layer stencil. And I love this stencil because you can color one side of the heart in one color ink and the other side of the heart in another color ink and have a really pretty background of hearts for your card. So I'm going to use the stencil, and I'm going to start out by stenciling that onto a piece of cardstock. So I have a piece of Bristol smooth cardstock that I cut to 4.25 by 5.5 inches. I will actually cut this down later on, but I am starting with a standard A2 size card front. I'll eventually cut this down to 4 1/8 by 5 3/8 so that I have a little bit of an edge for when I put this on my card base. So I lay down stencil layer A, which is the left side of the hearts, and I'm going to be using the Abandoned Coral Distress Oxide ink for this stencil. Once I'm done inking up that stencil, I will remove it and line up stencil layer B, which is the right side of the hearts. And for this stencil, I'm going to be using the Seedless Preserves Distress Oxide ink. It's a really pretty purple color, and I'll go ahead and ink up all of the openings of this stencil. Now, I'm using 2 different color inks, but of course, if you wanted your hearts to all be one color, you can just use the one color on both stencils. So now I'm finished inking up both stencils, so I'll go ahead and remove that and look at that beautiful design on that card panel. All right, so now I'm going to do some coloring. I stamped out one of the cupcakes from the Valentine Cupcakes stamp set. I have this cute little dog holding the heart in its mouth. I'm using my Zig Clean Color Real Brush pens to color my images. So for the dog, I'm using the sand color, and then I'm using the blender marker to blend that brown color towards the center. That way it's darker on the edges and lighter in the middle. I'm also using that same sand color to color his ears, adding a little bit of the marker towards the top of the ear, and then bringing the blender down so that it's faded into a lighter color. I'm making that little spot on his eye a little bit lighter by using the flesh color marker. And for the heart, I'm using the light carmine, which is a very light red, as well as the blender. And then for the cupcake wrapper, I'm going to switch between the purple marker and the light carmine. So I'll color one row with the purple, the next row with the light carmine, and then the bottom row I'll color with the purple. And I'm also using my blender marker to blend that color so that it's also lighter towards the center. And for the nose, I'm using the sugar almond pink. I'm also going to be using a couple of the chocolates and some of the hearts from the Sweet Chocolates stamp set. So I'm coloring up the hearts in the same color that I used for the cupcake wrapper. So we're using purple and light carmine for those hearts. And I'm going to bring in all of those same colors for the chocolates as well. So for this first chocolate, I'm using the light carmine as well as the blender to color that chocolate up. And then for the sprinkles, I'll be using the purple color and coloring all of those sprinkles in the purple. And for my last chocolate, I'm using the mid-brown color. I'm making this actually look like a dark chocolate piece of candy, which I didn't put that much brown initially, but I am going to go back and add here a second layer of the brown because I needed to darken this up. So I just put it along the edges and then use my blender marker to blend that towards the center. So these zig markers, they are water-based, and if you don't have a blender marker, you can always use a paintbrush dipped in water or a water brush. I love using these zig markers because they're so easy to color with, and you really can get a nice shaded look by just blending out the color either with water or with the blender marker, and it's just so easy. So I will have a list of all of the colors that I used on my blog. If you're interested in duplicating any of these colors, you can head over to my blog and take a look at that. Off camera, I do die cut these with the coordinating dies, but I'm going to go ahead and move on to this eyelet heart die set that I used to die cut this heart out of some white cardstock. This is the largest heart in the set. And what I'm doing is I just took a piece of mint tape and put it right down the middle, and I want to make this look very similar to that stenciled background. So I'm adding the Seedless Preserves ink on the right, and then I'm going to move my mint tape over to the opposite side, and I am going to add the Abandoned Coral ink to the left side. So I think this really goes along with that theme of the stencil by having the red on the left and the purple on the right. And this heart is actually going to be where I'm going to layer all of my stamps on top of. I am going to add a smaller heart right on top. And this one I just die cut out of white cardstock. I'm not going to ink that up at all. I'm just going to add it right to the top. So here I'm going to arrange my stamped images onto my hearts. I really think by having that white heart in the background, it really makes those images pop. If I would have put them on the inked heart, I think they would blend a little bit in with the colors that I chose to color them with because they're all very similar colors. So adding that white, it really helps them stand out against that background and really makes it pop. So I'm just layering up the chocolates with the dog and adding the hearts there. I think this is so cute. I'm also going to work on my sentiment. I die cut the words "Be mine" out of white cardstock. You can see there that I left the words inside of the white cardstock. It's just easier for me to add color this way. And I'm using those same two colors of the zig markers that I colored my stamps with. This is the light carmine and the purple. And I'm just adding the light carmine to the top of the words. And then I'm going to add the purple color towards the bottom, and then I will bring those together with my water brush. And I'm just dragging that purple color towards the red color. You can also drag the red color down so you can see how you're just pulling the color to make a nice gradient of color. So it's darker at the top, lighter in the middle, and then darker at the bottom. Next, I did take them out of the cardstock and there was a little bit of a white edge, and I'm just taking my water brush and just pulling that ink down to cover up that white edge on the cardstock. And I die cut the shadow layer out of white cardstock, and now I'm just going to glue the words that I used the zig markers on, and I'll just glue that to the shadow layer. And you really can see that pop of color when those watercolored words are added to the white shadow layer. I think that is so pretty. Next, I'm going to add the words "Be mine" to the bottom of my card panel. Once I have my words added, I'll go ahead and add my heart. And then I'll go ahead and add this to a white A2 size card base. Next, I'm going to use a white gel pen. I'm just adding some white accents on all of my stamped images. And finally, I'm going to use my Pops of Color, and this is the Raspberry Kiss color. It matches perfectly with that purple color in that card, and I'm just adding a few dots just to add some more color to the white heart. The Pops of Color is a liquid embellishment, so it will need to dry before you handle your card, but once dry, it does dry hard. So that will complete my card using the brand new products from the Pretty Pink Posh release for January of 2024. And as always, if you liked this video, please click that thumbs up button. And if you like videos like this and want to see more, please consider subscribing to the Pretty Pink Posh YouTube channel. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye-bye.